What is going on, everyone? Welcome to another edition of the NBL Live Pregame Show that's brought to you each and every week by our graphic sponsor, Web3KS.com. We talk about them all the time here on the network. They do so much for our entire NBL platform. If you or anyone you know needs graphics done for a affordable price, hit up Web3KS.com. Let them know NBL sent you. You'll get 15% off your entire order. Web3KS.com, the leaders in affordable graphic design. Thanks for hanging out with us, folks. I am OSU. I'm hanging out with my man, the Commissioner Bomber. We got two fantastic games on hand for you tonight. On one side, you're going to see the San Francisco 49ers taking on the Carolina Panthers. On the other side, the Oakland Raiders take on the Pittsburgh Steelers. Bomber, NBL Live 268. We're seeing a whole lot of teams here. We get a little bit of a repeat. We're getting to see the San Francisco 49ers again, the Pittsburgh Steelers again. Both these teams looking for a little redemption on NBL Live. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to put enough together to get their first wins on the season.
Yeah, you look at the San Francisco 49ers title of his private stream right now, and it says, "Can I just get one win, please," or something of that sort. Darth Bin looking for his first win in NBL Season 36. I want to give a shout-out to the chat right now. Agent Rico, he's a Tier 2 subscriber. He's in the chat right now. Spongy's in the chat. Draco Porter's going to be playing, and he's in the chat. OSU doesn't like that, so we'll be monitoring that as that game kicks off to see if I can gas OSU up to kind of go after Porter. Brad's in the chat, of course, from the grid. I think he's got 80%, 88% participation in the grid. Shout out to him, the number one prospect in the grid right now. I appreciate everybody coming by, stopping by. But yeah, we get to see the 49ers tonight, Carolina Panthers. Hopefully, Carolina Panthers are highlighting and making some big plays because, you know, Porter's trying to show out here on the big stage, on the big show, NBL Live.
Got a lot to get to. Let's get right to it. Let's take a look at our players to watch for today's NBL Live Super Show. Broadcast 268. Let's start out with the Panthers and the 49ers. And for the Carolina Panthers, Luke Kuechly is this defensive leader bomber. And he's always been known as a guy who gets in the backfield, creates havoc. But this season, 20 tackles, one forced fumble, but he has 5 interceptions. And a lot of that work is down inside the goal line. If you're the San Francisco 49ers bomber, how do you account for Luke Kuechly each and every play and make sure you don't give the Panthers extra possessions?
Yeah, you just got to find him pre-snap. Before the ball's hiked, the quarterback has to get to the line of scrimmage, look at the defense, assess the defense, but most importantly, he has to call out and mic Luke Kuechly. This is the guy you want to watch. He does doesn't do maybe too much blitzing, so maybe you want to mic him too much. But at 0-8, that's a guy you definitely have to look for, starting quarterback for the San Francisco 49ers. They say it might be Joe Flacco tonight. I'm thinking they're going to stay with Jimmy Garoppolo. Breda's averaging 2.7 yards per carry. So Keekly's going to be able to make his force felt, so you have to recognize where he's at. So here's what you do. You run away from him, and you pass away from him. Two simple rules that we can start the game with. Stay away from him. He's going to be in the middle of the field lurking. He just came away with a game-winning interception versus the Tampa Bay Buccaneers last week, a game that came down to the very end, and it was almost some fluky stuff against the Carolina Panthers, but they were able to hang on due to the wonderful middle linebacker, Luke Kuechly, and future free agent in NBL Season 37. You heard it here first.
On the flip side, how about we talk about Joe Flacco, the guy who I think many are expecting to get the start today. He hasn't had a whole lot of action, 54.6 passer rating, 230 yards, 1 touchdown, 3 interceptions. They brought in Joe Flacco, bomber, not because of talent, not because of how good of a quarterback is. It's purely personal bias. We know DB loves the Baltimore Ravens. Bringing in Joe, they played well, really well, actually. Last time on NBL Live, bomber, you weren't here, but the 49ers looked really well. We're very close to pulling off a huge win. Couldn't do it. If you're the 49ers, you're starting Joe Flacco. Does that give you more confidence knowing you have a veteran at the quarterback position?
Yeah, and I think Joe Flacco's gonna do a phenomenal job understanding the value of throwing away from Luke Kuechly. I think Jimmy Garoppolo gets a little gun happy early into the especially into the game. He likes to take those shots deep. We've seen that with the San Francisco 49ers. Even though I missed the previous game on NBL Live with the Niners, I know he likes to take shots deep down the game early in the game. I think Joe Flacco will give them that sense of stability that they need offensively, and he will definitely be able to, you know, pick out Luke Kuechly all over the field as they like to move him around in Carolina.
On the flip side, we got an AFC battle between the Raiders and the Steelers. Looking at the Oakland Raiders, there haven't been a whole lot of bright spots this year, bomber, but Carl Joseph continues to be a force on that defense. 34 tackles, 2 picks. He also has a pass deflected and a sack on the season. This guy, while the Raiders' defense has actually been pretty bad most of the year, Carl Joseph's find a way to make some of those big plays. If you're the Oakland Raiders, how much are you leaning on Carl Joseph to be the catalyst for that defense?
Yeah, he's got to make plays at the safety position. He's the captain of this defense on the season. He's only had 2 interceptions, a sack. He's second on the team in tackles, right behind Morris Christian. Carl Joseph at that strong safety position, being only 26 years old, he is the veteran of this very young ball club. I expect him to make a lot of plays tonight. He's all over the ball. He's a ball hawk. He's 94 overall. He's got the speed, agility, acceleration. He can get it done, and he has the great zone coverage to find an ability to kind of bait the quarterback into bad throws. And hopefully we see it tonight, and he gets a second interception on the season.
On the flip side, the Pittsburgh Steelers still looking for their first win on the season. T.J. Watt has been a bright spot, though, for the defense with 7 sacks already on the season. He also has a forced fumble and a pick from that outside linebacker position. Bomber, we know that the Pittsburgh Steelers aren't going to have Antonio Brown today, so how important is it going to be for the Pittsburgh Steelers, their defense, to get some extra possessions, losing a guy as talented as Antonio Brown?
Antonio Brown being out hasn't had the greatest Madden 19 cycle, OSU. Probably one of his down cycles here in the NBL. We haven't seen too much for him. And that's not really a knock on current ownership, as they got him at 33 years old. Previous ownership didn't really utilize him to the ability, as he is the cover athlete of Madden 19. And he has yet to get over 1,000 yards receiving in any NBL season so far, and this is our fourth one. So without Antonio Brown, you're going to look at this defense, and so far this defense has been 30th in points allowed, 29th in yards allowed, but they are 6th against the pass and 6th against the rush somehow. I don't know how that is, but maybe they're just on the cusp of when you add it together, it puts them at 29th. Maybe they're including some special teams. I don't know. But yeah, 28 points per game. The defense has to get it going. You can't allow that many points. And good thing for them, because tonight they're playing an Oakland Raiders team who doesn't put many points on the board. This is a team that came into this season. They only average 11 points per game, OSU. So you got a team that gives up 28 and the team that only scores 11. So maybe it'll fall somewhere in the middle for these ball clubs, and both of them be happy with that.
You got to think some of the reason why they're so good yardage-wise is there's so many turnovers that give the offense short fields a lot. So there just isn't that many 80-yard drives against the Steelers team. Before we get to your pick, let's take a look at the Bleacher Report. Their team, what they decided was going to be the favorites for this week's game. Everybody going with the Oakland Raiders except for old Adam Schlamberg going with the Pittsburgh Steelers. On the flip side, Darth Ben not picking because he's a part of it, and it doesn't matter because nobody's picking him either. They're all going Carolina Panthers. Cougs still sitting there with a very impressive 9-1 record. Next closest looks like Draco at 8-3, so Cougs a stern lead there. Bomber, let's get to your picks. Who do you think is going to win today's Super Show matchup? Let's start out with that matchup in Carolina. Actually, in San Francisco. Carolina and San Francisco, do the 49ers grant the wish to owner Darth Ben? Do they get their one win tonight?
I think tonight is going to be a blowout, 44-7. Shout out to Draco. It's going to be Porter over the San Francisco 49ers. I like to take the home team usually, but not when the home team's at his mom's house. Darth Ben, it ain't happening tonight. The San Francisco 49ers are going to go down. It's going to look pretty bad. I go 44-7. I'm just going to throw that number out there. Those two numbers.
How about the flip side? Only one win between the Raiders and Steelers. Steelers looking for their first win. Raiders looking to double their win total. Who's coming out on top in this AFC matchup?
You know, I like the Raiders, believe it or not. I like everything until they throw that interception. It's really a crazy phenomenon in Oakland. I like what Derek Carr does as he drives the ball down the field. He moves the ball down the field, and then he gets to that one point where I just go, don't throw it there. Why are you throwing it there? Don't do it. Don't do it. And it's usually an interception. I like the home team, Pittsburgh Steelers. They're 0-8. I think it's time for them to get a victory. I'm going Pittsburgh Steelers tonight. It's going to be 17-13. Pittsburgh over the Oakland Raiders. You heard it here first.
Only one way to find out. Let's see if two of
That's
these winless
teams.
That's
my new thing, too. I'm just like saying it. That. I don't know why.
It's a nice catchphrase.
Well, it's not mine. Obviously, it was going to be going through the copyright thing.
Got it. Yeah, we'll trademark it by the end.
Call me, Vince McMahon. Give me a call. I'm still waiting.
Thank you so much for tuning into the NBL Live pregame show. Let's see if some of these winless teams can get their first win on the night. Coming up next, it's NBL Live Broadcast 268. Panthers and 49ers on one side, Raiders and Steelers on the other. It's all coming up right now here on NBL Live.
I just want to say, hey, man, this is T.O., the cover athlete of the Madden 19 Hall of Fame edition, and you're watching the gold standard of the franchise mode, the NBL Network. Holla.
And we are live. We got NBL Live Super Show action here. Little midweek hump day NBL Live. It's broadcast 268 here on the NBL Network. Thank you so much for tuning in and hanging out with us on this Wednesday night. I am OSU. I'm hanging out with my man, the Commissioner Bomber. You can see dual screen action. On the left side, you've got the Panthers and 49ers. Right side, Steelers and Raiders. Two very interesting matchups, Bomber. One of them, we're pretty sure will be pretty competitive. One of them, we're all just praying for DB.
Yeah, I think the Carolina Panthers are going to run away with this. They're going to get the ball first, an opportunity to set the tone here in Carolina. A couple of guys are asking the spreads for the game, so I'm going to get that pulled up. OSU, we got two matchups today. Obviously, Carolina's favored by 17 on the road. They're minus 17. The over and under is 37 for those following along in our cashing out.
Should have been a pick on the first throw, by the way. Should have been a pick for Jameis Winston on the first throw. Hit him right in the hands. Carry on.
Okay. It's the Pittsburgh Steelers over there. I didn't even have that one pulled up. I was looking at this cashing out. Opportunity to win $1,000. Go to MaddenBomberLeague.com. All you need is a Daddy Leagues account. And then the other game, which is the Pittsburgh Steelers taking on the Oakland Raiders. It's going to be Oakland minus 7, and the over and under is 36. So you got a 37 over and under in San Francisco, Carolina, a 36. So very predictive of some low-scoring games. There's a nice run there by Darden on the right side, picking up 17 yards.
Back from injury, hasn't been around. They're happy to have him back in Pittsburgh. On the left side of your screen, it's the Carolina Panthers. It's a handoff on first down to Christian McCaffrey. He's got a big hole, a really bad user dive on the left side of the field. 14 yards for C-Mac, right up the middle. It's a first down for both these teams, establishing a little bit of a run game. Early in this matchup, let's go over to the right side of the screen where we see Jameis Winston, Mason Rudolph. They tried that out. Didn't go great. Jameis Winston back in the under center for the Pittsburgh Steelers. On first and 10, it's a handoff to Wilcox over the left side. He is stopped at the line of scrimmage at the 44-yard line on first and 10. Throw over to the right side. Has a man. It is who else but DJ Moore. Mr. 99 breaks a tackle down to the 25-yard line. Deshaun Watson putting it on the money. And Bomber, Carolina hasn't been overly happy with how Deshaun Watson has played, especially with the talent that's around him, but they're still very hopeful they can win a division title this year.
Yeah, you heard some birds chirping earlier as Deshaun Watson didn't start off the first 2 to 3 games. He was injured. They had Matt Stafford as a backup. Stafford was slinging it, looking great, very much reminding them of what they had with Cam Newton, which they're very comfortable with. Let's see if Watson can get some confidence here against the Niners as he just takes a sack there from Armstead.
Oh, Bradford, a nice carry over the right side, or a nice catch on the right side. Jameis Winston finding the halfback. Actually, I think that's it's a former Atlanta Falcon. I think that's Pearson Bradford. Thanks for taking him off my practice squad, you jerk. Second down and 20 for the Carolina Panthers. On the left side of your screen, four wide receivers, 2 DBs, Shad, Christian McCaffrey in the backfield with Deshaun Watson surveying the San Francisco defense. Got to hand it off to C-Mac right up the middle on a draw play. Good early hit. It looks like San Francisco's got aggressive tackle on Bomber because we're seeing a lot of missed tackles early.
Yeah, absolutely. The Niners have aggressive tackle on. The owner's on a premium aggressive tackle where he's just hit stick diving and face planting early in this game. The Carolina Panthers do find themselves in a 3rd and 18, though. It's time for DJ Gimme Moore to make a play.
Yes, that is definitely Pearson Bradford. Ratting off my practice squad. What a jerk. 3rd and 18. Shotgun formation for Deshaun Watson. He's got three wide receivers, two in the backfield with him in the shotgun as he drops back. Four-man rush from the San Francisco 49ers. Dropping back, waiting, looks deep down the middle of the field, and a nice play back to the quarterback, able to stick his hand up and deflect that ball. And the San Francisco 49ers bomber, listen, we're not saying the 49ers are going to win this game, but this has got to be a small victory for a 49ers defense that has been victimized this year.
There's a bunch of wins that can happen today, and one of them is holding the Carolina Panthers to 3 at any point during the game. Right now, they're celebrating in San Francisco somewhere. They're cracking open a brewski. They're cheersing up because they know that was a big-time play there by that middle linebacker, number 53. And you wonder who that is. You're saying, oh, is that Navarro Bowman? No, it's absolutely not. We're obviously in four seasons in. He's not there anymore. I'll have the name on that guy in here in just a second. I thought I was going to be able to pull it up while I just kind of BS'd and talked.
Didn't go well.
No. And find it.
What a catch in traffic by Williams. Mike Williams stays down, though. Big shout out to Pug Memes SD with the follow here on Twitch. Appreciate it, my friend. A big first down there is Jameis Winston leading this nice drive for the Pittsburgh Steelers against the Oakland Raiders. They're down inside the 8-yard line as we go full screen here in Pittsburgh. Heinz Field, look at those ketchup bottles. Fun fact about OSU, hates ketchup. Hate him. Absolutely
really?
Hate him. Yeah, hate ketchup.
Please, what do you eat with your French fries? Not ketchup?
Nothing.
I bet you use mayonnaise.
Nope.
You seem like a mayonnaise guy.
Nope. I mean, if it's not covered in gravy and cheese curds, I eat it plain.
What is cheese curds like? Is a little run to the right side there for Darden. Is that a good thing? That's a Canadian thing, man. I almost got it at some
It's just
place.
Cheese. It's just less melty cheese. It's good.
Is it
it's
good, fine. Though?
I mean,
is it?
I like it.
Okay. It's a little intimidating when you get cheese a certain way.
Welcome
and you see
to the
that
network,
and
baby.
Like, I don't know too much about that.
Shout out to Roll Tide 15 with the sub here on Twitch. As you see on the small screen, you can keep up with San Francisco and Carolina as Jerick McKinnon just went down with an injury. Boy, I haven't been able to keep him healthy at all. I assume these are gifts coming in.
Yeah, we got five subs. Tier one subs. We got from Gov. Shout out to Gov. The governor been just coming through with these subscription giveaways. Stringer, Tony 210.
Hold on, he did.
Yeah, he did.
Woo! Washington with the catch, a tight window throw from Jameis Winston, and bomber. That is what they have been waiting for from Jameis Winston, making some of these tough throws and finding a way to give Pittsburgh an early lead.
Welcome to the network,
nice
baby.
Nice little pitch and catch to the left side. Just a little slant play as the San Francisco 49ers completely 3-and-out on their first drive. It's good to see the 0-8 Pittsburgh Steelers drive down on the first drive of the game, hold the ball for 3 minutes, well, 2 minutes and 59 seconds.
Welcome to the network, baby.
And end with
baby.
A touchdown on a drive that started with what, an OSU? A bad throw from Jameis Winston that could have been picked.
Jay Ports with get a sub there, by the way. Also, Jerick McKinnon.
Yeah, we got subs. Let me call them out real quick. You got Tony 210, Stringer 18, JB the Container, Roll Tide 15X, and then the governor also gifted a tier one sub to Jay Porter, my long lost rival. He's been hiding from me so far in the last couple months, ever since the Call of Duty fiasco, but he's here to support T Porter. Shout out to Jay Ports. I hope all is well.
All the great Call of Duty incident of 2018, of course, is what everybody knows. As we go back to double box action, Pittsburgh up 7-0 early in that game. Carolina up 3-0, getting the ball back after a quick 3-and-out from Joe Flacco and the San Francisco 49ers. And now San Francisco, another opportunity to get off the field here with a 3rd and 13. You know they're probably going to be looking for Mr. 99, DJ Moore. Handoff over the right side for the Oakland Raiders. He's got some room. He's got the first down and more. That's Taquan Jasper with the carry down the 14-yard line. He has been so impressive early in the season. 3rd and 13 for the Carolina Panthers. Pressure on Watson. Just gets it off and just completes it over on the left side. His big shout out with Dubers with the sub. How did Deshaun Watson get that over to Bird? It was good coverage, and somehow the man coverage just let that ball get over his head.
That's dotty dot dot. That's when the quarterback throws the ball, and the defender's like, no way that's coming to me. And he's almost shocked that the pass was thrown, but that's what Porter does. He puts a lot of pressure on this defense because he will try to slice and dice it into a covered offensive player, as you saw in that 3rd and long.
Boy, and it looked like San Francisco might get a sack. They might get the deflection. It turns into a completion as Gonzalez with the catch there. They got their star tight end back. Boy, if you can't get off the field on 3rd and 13 against this Panthers team, you're in for a rough day as a false start for the fullback for the Oakland Raiders. Derek Carr drawn back on 1st and 15 and throws it in between two wide receivers looking for Sowles or the fullback. Not really clear. Little triple option action over for the Carolina Panthers, pitching it to Christian McCaffrey. Had no need to actually pitch it because there was nobody there, but he wanted C-Mac to have the ball. He picks up 7, going to bring up a 2nd and 3. Again, appreciate everybody tuning in to NBL Live tonight. Little midweek NBL Live. I'm OSU. I'm hanging out with my man, the Commissioner Bomber, NBL Live 268 here on the NBL Network. 2nd down and 3, dropping back. Deshaun Watson looking deep down the field. Has a man. It is DJ Moore inside the 15 down to the 13-yard line. Another throw to DJ Moore. And Bomber, you're going to see that all day long. If you try to go one-on-one with DJ Moore, you're going to get burned.
Yeah, absolutely. DJ Moore just a little post, takes it across the field, just hangs with the route, and it seems like Deshaun Watson and DJ Moore are finally getting that chemistry built up. Is this their first season playing together? Carolina looks to be really exciting, but they are playing the San Francisco 49ers.
1st down and 10. Looking over to the right side, it's DJ Moore once again on a little drag route. He'll get down to the 5-yard line. So we'll stay full screen here with Carolina inside the red zone all the way down to the 5. Big 3rd and 3 for the Oakland Raiders on the small screen. On the left side, it's Derek Carr in the shotgun with 3 wide receivers set. Taquan Jasper on his left hip looking to respond to that early Pittsburgh Steelers touchdown. Pittsburgh moving guys around, dropping back. They're going to just pitch it out to Jasper. And great open field tackle there, bringing down Jasper before the line to gain. Bomber, that is so key against this Raiders team, not letting Taquan Jasper get loose with a broken tackle.
And Taquan Jasper has been phenomenal. He was a top 10 draft pick, the 8th overall pick in the NBL season 35 rookie draft. That was just a season ago. We're currently in NBL season 36. He's out of Oklahoma, 88 speed, 93 excel with 95 agility. And he just has seemed to be very elusive coming into this NBL culture here. He's been phenomenal. I've liked what I've seen from Taquan Jasper. Just couldn't pick up the first down there.
And now a 3rd and 6 after they had a 3rd and short, a false start for the Carolina Panthers. Big mistake. I formation for Deshaun Watson, dropping back to pass on 3rd down. Waiting, looking. He's got some room. It looks like he's going to take off. He throws the defense. He dives into the end zone, takes a big hit, but he scores. It's a touchdown for the Panthers. And oh boy, Bomber. They don't like seeing Deshaun Watson take hits like that, but what a great move there, freezing the defense for 0.5 seconds. Looked like he was going to throw it, and then he takes off and well, walks into the end zone before he is launched while in the end zone.
Yeah, you look at Deshaun Watson on this team. They signed him to a big contract, over $100 million. He's making $19 million right now. He didn't play the first two games of the season. He's kind of got off to a slow start, including a string of five games where he had under a 95 QBR in three of those.
Big return
for
the 49ers, though.
He's
to the 40. He's to the 30, the 20, 15, 10, 5. If you can't get your offense to do it, get your special teams to do it. As San Francisco responds to the touchdown. Boy, I'm glad we were full screen on that one. As a huge special teams play and bomber. How often do we see games decided by momentum swinging plays like that? San Francisco, who has been pretty much dominated this game, they cut it back to 10-7.
Yeah, you want to know how often? I mean, take a look at the Cleveland Browns playoff runs in NBL season 33 and 34. It was just a phenomenal run by him because of his special teams. I mean, being able to get those kick returns that not only put you in great field position, and sometimes they put points on the board.
Uh-oh, big return for the Panthers. Right back past the 40, 45. He steps out of bounds. Ah, he was almost gone. But down to the 47-yard line as we'll go back to the double box. These games both live here on the network. Appreciate everybody hanging out with us. I'm OSU. I'm hanging with Bomber. Bomber, so far, both these games providing a lot of action. This Oakland-Pittsburgh game, it's going to be a low-scoring battle because these teams, they're not very explosive, but they're very methodical as they work down the field.
Absolutely. They're going to get into third and longs, third and intermediate, third and sevens. And if they can pick those up and keep the drives alive, we're going to see a lot of long drives, 3 to 4 minutes off the game clock.
Big run over the left side for Darden back for the Pittsburgh Steelers this year. This week, as he was hurt prior to this week, was out for a couple weeks. They're happy to have their running back back. Second and five, I formation for Deshaun Watson. Christian McCaffrey at the top of the I, two wide receivers over to the left side, one tight end on the right side of the formation. Devin Funchess coming in motion on second down, bringing both wide receivers tight to the line, dropping back as Watson. Blitz picked up nicely, looks over to the right side, has a man. It is Devin Funchess down to the 35-yard line. Give him 13 yards on the play, Bomber. That's the thing about this Carolina team is with Gonzalez, with Funchess, with DJ Moore, there are just so many weapons. It's hard to play man coverage against the athleticism this Panthers team has.
Absolutely. They got speed for days. Bird even out there, number 18, getting it done. Deshaun Watson looking healthy. That's a positive sign. As we said, it was a rocky start to the season, missing the first two games and struggling. And as I say that, right on cue, pressure gets to Deshaun Watson. Did we have that play pulled up on there?
Oh, yeah. We had it. Oh, we had it good.
Oh, what is he doing?
Waiting and waiting and waiting. And giving the San Francisco 49ers a free possession, which is huge for this 49ers team looking to get something going offensively. First down and 10 for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Darden with the carry. Oh, let go of the turbo, man. Just patience. Patience is a virtue. He gets 9 yards, but boy, he had a lot of open field in front of him. As oh, a nice run here for the 49ers.
Woo!
Makes one man miss.
Okay.
Juke move. Okay. 15 down inside the 15 to the 12-yard line. Jericho, Matt Breda showing off the moves as he avoids the diving tackle. A little shifty juke move, and the 49ers are down to the 12-yard line. Bomber, we saw this on NBA Live last Friday. The 49ers did what they did on the ground, and Matt Breda, a big reason for that.
Yeah, I can hear Darth Bin right now yelling at the top of his lungs. I might do it, Mama. I might do it. I might get that W.
Pearson Bradford, he's getting to the pylon. Touchdown, Steelers, as Bradford took the drag route underneath and took it to the house. What were the Falcons thinking letting this guy sit on their practice squad? He finds the end zone. Pittsburgh a two-score lead as the 49ers throws it out to the flat. Has a man, Taylor, a horrible user on defense out there, picking up 11 down to the one-yard line. Action all over the place here on NBL Live.
The Pittsburgh Steelers looking phenomenal, up 14-0. They're 0-8. I couldn't be happier for them. I did pick them. I said 17-13, so the scoring's going to have to slow down a little bit. But the Carolina Panthers are in big-time trouble right now. Ports is a perpetual choke artist.
How about
artist,
Matt Breda? Just
and we're
walk
seeing
into
it right
the
now.
Zone.
Breda, I got him on my fantasy team.
49ers.
Let's go, baby.
They got a lead here at home against the Panthers. It was 10-0. The kickoff return, the fumble by Watson. And now, everybody take a screenshot right now for DB's mama. It's 14-10, 49ers on top. And DB's like, can we end the game here? Is there a virus I can put into the game where this is just the final score? I love it. Love seeing DB on top.
Darth Bin, I mean, these are two winless teams with leads right now on NBL Live Broadcast 268. It can't be greater than this. Even though if you're a Panther or Raiders fan, you're a little disappointed right now.
Yeah, it could be greater for sure. So we're going to go back to the double box action. It's been a lot of action early here on NBL Live 268. The Steelers up 14-0. Two very good drives. The Oakland Raiders, they've only had the ball once, and they put together a fairly methodical drive. They converted 3 out of 4 third downs. Unfortunately, The fourth one was on the other side of the 50. So Pittsburgh got the ball back, and then Pearson Bradford with his touchdown on the day. Second down attempt for Derek Carr and the Oakland Raiders. Dropping back to pass on second down, looking underneath, completes it on the drag route, just shy of the first down marker to the 27-yard line. It's going to bring up a third and one as Deshaun Watson completing it underneath to the 8-yard line. Going to bring up a second and two. A couple second and short and bomber. Is there any reason for Carolina to panic right now?
Not yet. I mean, you still have DJ Moore. You got Bird number 18 on the outside. Gonzalez at your tight end position. You got a lot of talent. Deshaun Watson still trying to prove himself in Carolina. I'll tell you what, if they do end up losing this game, everybody who wanted Watson out of the lineup come week five, week six, after he posted that 25 QBR, they're going to be calling for his head again, saying go back to Matt Stafford.
Boy, the man coverage, though, for the San Francisco 49ers has been pretty tough to watch. As Watson's 9 of 10 on the day, and a lot of it in man coverage. What sort of adjustments do you make if you're San Francisco bomber trying to adjust to the athleticism of the Carolina Panthers?
You just got to get more pressure. I mean, I would even kill the cover one. Maybe just go cover zero and see if you can get to the quarterback quicker and try to make a play before he can just find his man down the field. A big hit there by number 54, laying the lumber on Christian McCaffrey.
Trey Turner going down on the offensive line. First and 10 for the Raiders. It's Taquan Jasper right up the middle. He gets to the 38-yard line. Three carries, 25 yards so far for Jasper. We saw him on NBL Live earlier this year against the Los Angeles Chargers. And Jasper was one of the names I said everybody should remember. He's a very athletic running back for this Oakland Raiders team that likes to use their running backs out of shotgun sets. He's got the speed to hit the hole, and he has been very good early in the season. Second and eight on the left side of your screen for the Carolina Panthers. It's Deshaun Watson dropping back to pass on second down. Looks over the middle of the field, has a man. Big hit on the tight end and pries that ball free. It's going to set him up to a third and eight. Trey Turner out with the abdominal tear and bomber. This is where the 49ers defense needs to come up with big plays. We've seen a big fumble.
Strip,
and Joe Schobert picks it up. Wow, a user strip for the Pittsburgh Steelers. They're going to get the ball. Huge play defensively. But this is where, as I was saying, this is where San Francisco's got to come up with some stops. If you can get them into third downs, you've got to get Carolina off the field.
Yeah, this is big for Carolina. This is an interception alert play right here. This is when Porter might try to force it down the field.
And he does force it down the field, but real poor safety play right there. As they let, looks like that was Gonzalez, make the catch in front of the deep safety, and they're all the way down to the 28-yard line. Carolina, they're going to spread him out once again. Empty backfield for Deshaun Watson on the left side of your screen. Looks like it's going to be a little jet sweep to Christian McCaffrey, and they had like eight players diving, but they're able to get to Christian McCaffrey in the backfield at the 33-yard line, losing five on the play, going to bring up a second and long.
Yeah, a little bit of a suspect play there, tackling an open field there for Darth Bin, but it pays off for him because Porter stayed on that, that common trajectory on the jet sweep. Instead of turning it upfield, maybe probably could have picked up a little bit more, but Porter's on the drive, on the roll right here, trying to drive down the field. Maybe they hold him to three and we celebrate again as the Niners might go in the halftime with the lead, the first time that has happened this season.
Second down and 15. Pistol formation. Bunch formation three to the left side. The tight end Gonzalez splitting out wide right. Looks like it's man coverage across the board once again. Let's see if they can take advantage of that. Blitz coming. It's picked up beautifully by the offensive line, and that allows for an easy pitch and catch over the middle, and you're seeing where San Francisco is struggling today, Bomber. They just don't have the talent up front to create any pressure, and if you give Deshaun Watson time, you're going to end up paying.
It's really because the wide receivers just get open. He has so much talent and so many options offensively. We talked about Bird, Funchess, and more also at the tight end position. Gonzalez is a dominant player. That's four dominant players out there right now looking to catch the ball. Very tough to defend if you don't get pressure.
Whoa,
to the
Monroe,
quarterback.
Wow, what a play. He brings down DJ Moore, but he almost went the other way. They brought the cover zero blitz and throws over to DJ Moore, who already has six catches on the day. Pittsburgh cannot capitalize, though, on that interception. As Allen's going to be forced to punt this away. Play a little field position, up 14-0. Dropping back to Deshaun Watson on second and six. Looks deep in the back of the end zone. Big hit, but Devin Funchess says,
baby,
that's mine. Brings it down the Carolina Panthers wide receivers, Bomber. I got to say, is this the best wide receiver core in the NBL right now?
It's the deepest, I think. I mean, we're talking three deep with a tight end that can get down the field as well. We're talking about Gonzalez. We saw him make a catch over the middle of the field. James Gonzalez has been phenomenal for these Carolina Panthers this season, NBL season 36. Let's see if they can keep this up. Deshaun Watson, the highest QBR he's posted this year is 112. He's hit as low as a 25. He's right now looking like he's going to surpass that by a lot. He might be rocking and rolling and ready to kind of hit this maybe postseason potentially for the Carolina Panthers.
Big tackle there as Taquan Jasper only picks up two on the play. First step for the 49ers looking to answer. They're still looking for their first win on the season. They're feeling confident after a couple big NBL Live performances. Play action pass for Joe Flacco dropping back on first down and 10. Oh, looks to the Nike
look
check.
At Darth
comeback.
Okay.
I didn't know Darth Bench could throw that route. How about DB with the throw to the comeback route and right on time?
Maybe it's the Joe Flacco effect. You get Flacco number six there. He's rocking and rolling and ready to make some throws today. He's feeling that veteran presence. It's giving everybody confidence. The line feels more confident. The receiver's more confident. That was just a perfectly timed throw and pitch and catch there for the San Francisco 49ers. Very impressive.
First down and 10. Shotgun formation for Joe Flacco. Dropping back on first down. Looks over the middle of the field. Yeah, okay, well, it was fun while it lasted. That one was a dead duck over the middle, and Walker says, thank you very much, DB. I love the gifts that you give me. As Meredith was not open, and it was probably the easiest interception of Walker's career.
And I believe that's Walker, the former Indianapolis Colt that led the league in interceptions in NBL season 33 with the interception there for the Carolina Panthers. Could be wrong.
Well, teach me to compliment everyone. A big shout out to Project Fat with the sub. Looking to the screen pass, it's caught. Can Christian McCaffrey make something out of this? He does. He's taken out of the 43-yard line. Picks up a yard after catching that. Wow, all the way back. Probably an 8-yard loss. Turns it into a 1-yard gain. A shout-out to Halal Tuna with the follow here on Twitch. Appreciate the love, my friends. Appreciate everybody hanging out with us here on Wednesday night. Second down and 10, play action pass for the Oakland Raiders. Derek Carr looking over the middle of the field. It's a bad pass. It's picked off by Hilton. As it was one-on-one, it was slightly overthrown, and Hilton makes a great catch. Juke move for James Gonzalez on the left side of your screen as Carolina down to the 32-yard line. And Bomber with only 51 seconds left. I feel it just sort of feels like if Carolina puts a touchdown on the board, this game's already out of reach.
Yeah, I think so as well. I mean, you get a two-score game. If they can get into the end zone, it'd be 24-14 going into halftime. I don't know if San Francisco can overcome that deficit, but hey, they already got a special teams touchdown. Maybe some miracle might happen. Shout out to Colonel Sanders. He gifted the sub to Project Fat.
Ah, Fat's got money. Make him pay for zone.
He's gifted 43 as James Gonzalez. Finding a way to get open there for the Carolina Panthers. 43 subs is gifted on our channel.
And tell Fat to stop being cheap. First and goal. Down at the 2-yard line for the Carolina Panthers, looking to punch this one in. 33 seconds and counting as he surveys the defense. Changing up the play. 3 wide receivers set for Watson. 2 over to the right side. 1 to the left side. Christian McCaffrey on his left hip. Gonzalez on his right hip. Driving back to pass. Looking. Watson's in the pocket. Stepping up. He's going to run. He's going to get taken down, but it's too late. He's already in the end zone, and that's 2 scramble touchdowns for the Carolina Panthers. Bomber, what is San Francisco doing, giving Deshaun Watson so much room to just sort of run about and find his way into the end zone? Look on the right side of your
baby.
Screen. It's George Kittle. He's to the 15, 10, 5, touchdown! Oh, on the small screen on the left side, George Kittle says, put me on the big screen, OSU, as he finds the end zone. One of the big signings for the Pittsburgh Steelers this offseason, and Bomber, dare I say the Pittsburgh Steelers at 0-8 are primed for their first win of the season.
Yeah, George Kittle not having the production he had in Jacksonville last season. That's only his second touchdown on the season.
Okay.
But he is the second with 300. What did we get?
Did you see it?
He roughed the kicker.
He got the timing for the block, comes around the edge, gets to the kicker, and jumps. Not dives. Jumps straight up in the air and just lands on the kicker.
I never do the jump. I always do the dive. But I did the dive once and missed it, and Draco told me that I should have jumped. And I was like, man,
okay,
I never
but
jumped.
He wasn't at the ball. He was
left
of the
kicker. Yeah, so he jumped, and when he landed on the kicker?
Yeah,
what?
He jumped so early. He jumped sort of about a yard and a half from where the ball was and just sort of landed feet first next to the kicker. It was probably the worst attempt.
It's all going downhill for the Oakland Raiders right now. They're really struggling right now.
John back, Derek Carr looks underneath, has a man. It's Taquan Jasper. Nice little juke move there from Jasper down to the 37-yard line. They're going to hit the 2-minute warning. As in the other game, Carolina up 24-14. And boy, Darth Ben's sitting there. His mom's just made him a nice plate of warm cookies and a cold glass of milk while he's playing his Madden game. And he's going to be sitting there going, boy, why did I throw that pick over the middle down 3? Now I'm down 10, and I was getting the ball to start the second half.
Yeah, it was an opportunity to kind of just close the deficit. Even if you just came away with a field goal, you at least tie the game up. Now you got an opportunity to take the lead in the second half, which you've never had this entire season. Mental mistakes like that just seem to plague the San Francisco 49ers offense, and we're continuing to see it today.
Update, they are, by the way, Nestle Toll House cookies. Absolutely 100% as first and 10 for the San Francisco 49ers. Handoff to Matt Breda over the left side. Nothing doing there. Nice completion on the right side of your screen by Derek Carr. to the tight end, who I pretty sure 5 out of 6 completions have been to the tight end. One's been to Taquan Jasper. Nothing doing, as that's Travis Kelce with his third catch on the day. Oakland utilizing the running backs and tight ends, but you're seeing what's the problem with the Oakland offense, Bomber? They can't find a way to get it to their wide receivers.
And they got some talent at the wide receiver position. You're talking Ryan Switzer and Deron Swells. He's got 10 catches, 150 yards, and he's a very fast wide receiver out there. He's number 11, with 96 speed, 95 excel. I'd like to see him get going, maybe take a big shot down the field.
Big sack on second down for Juwan Lett, the rookie for the Carolina Panthers, getting the sack, setting up into a 3rd and 17, and I think everybody's got their INT alert on right now. 3rd down and 17, 3-man rush from the Carolina Panthers, looks deep down the middle of the field, and boy, DB made me look silly there. It's a beautiful throw to the tight end over the middle. I don't know, that was a cover 3, and it was all out of sorts as they pick up the first down, and Bomber, San Francisco, and Darth Ben as a deep pass right side, has a man! Touchdown, Raiders, right over the tap! Oh, what a throw from Derek Carr as Souls with the catch, and Bomber, tell me again what his speed is.
We got 96 speed, 95 excel. He was drafted the 17th pick in the second round, NBL season 34 rookie draft. This is a guy that had 785 yards and 6 touchdowns last season. I expected more production from him this year. He's been battling injury, but he's back, baby. He's back. Second game back and gets a big touchdown right there. Puts them, you know, within striking distance here. Now they just need the defense to come away with the big play.
They need to stop here because the Oakland Raiders do get the ball to start the second half. So that's a huge touchdown, and boy, what a burner they got on the left side as he left the defender in the dust. 2nd down and 4 for the San Francisco 49ers, handoff to Matt Breda. I have no idea why they cut him back inside. Why
Trent
that
Richardson,
inside?
Part 2 is alive here with Breda.
Shout out to TR.
Going to the left, wide open. You just have to trust your blocking. There was no reason to break that run off. He busts it back inside. I don't like the decision right there. Obviously, that would have been an easy-peasy first down.
1st and 10 on the right side of your screen for Jameis Winston and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Washington coming to motion, going to be a toss put at Darden over the left side. Oh, what a spin move. He's got a 1st down and more. Juke moved down to the 43-yard line. Oh, Darden with a nasty spin move. Had 2 guys over pursue him, and he goes, I'll just get a little spin cycle and pick up the 1st down. What a run from the Steelers. Bomber, the Steelers' run game has been really good today with the return of Darden.
Marshall Darden from Florida State. He was the 12th pick in the NBL season 34 rookie draft. Hasn't lived up to expectation. His highest season he posted was 430 yards. He does have all that
deep
ability and all that potential.
Washington. This is a big play here. Oh, he made the catch over the defender. Oh, what were they doing deep down the field? Bracket coverage and Howell straight up missed. A prayer to Washington, and it is answered as Pittsburgh scores quickly to respond. We haven't even hit halftime, and Pittsburgh already at 27 points. Ball is down, kick is up, and Pittsburgh has reclaimed their 21-point lead.
Yeah, you're running that cover 2 zone right there. That means the safety on the go route on the left side. He's going to be one-on-one with the wide receiver, Washington. Washington makes some pay. You got to switch on and use that.
Flacco's chucking it up to the end zone. One-on-one. And it's caught in the end zone. Oh, Meredith with the catch. So back-to-back prayers are answered for the winless teams in these games. All Jesus is looking down saying, I want these boys to get their one win. The 49ers, a huge touchdown on their first drive of the second half. It's back to a 3-point game. Bomber, I'm going to have to start praying harder because I need some of my prayers to be answered in Atlanta.
Hey, NBL Live is kicking off. Broadcast number 268 is feeling great. A deep shot down the field by Flacco. Everything looked good about that throw until he winded it up, and then the defender pretty much closed it out entirely. But then he gets mossed and he makes a big-time play. So we got 2 games that are just really cooking right now.
Are they going to force it down the field? Nice throw over the middle as it's complete to Souls. Once again, down to the 48-yard line. Derek Carr trying to get something going. Boy, they felt like they were in great position, and then their defense let them down. Already 28 points in the first half for the winless, by the way. Yes, it is the Pittsburgh Steelers who are winless in that game. They've got a 21-point lead. Carolina taking on the winless San Francisco 49ers. They're only up 3 in a dogfight right now. Bunch formation 3 to the left side. It's going to be a toss play to Christian McCaffrey. There's not a lot over there. McCaffrey has a lot of room. Watch the spin move. Oh, he went for the juke move. And a nice cutting tackle.
Yeah, I think the spin move, he's walking in.
He's in. He's gone. So it was a fumble for the Derek Carr and the Raiders. It's picked up by the Steelers. 24 seconds left. TJ Watt with the recovery, and it's all gone downhill for the Oakland Raiders. Bomber, we have mirror opposites of what we thought was going to happen. The game we thought was going to be a blowout is close, and the game we thought was going to be close, the Pittsburgh Steelers just said, nah, man, we got this.
Yeah, it seems like the Steelers are juiced. They got the JUIs today. They're 0-8 right now, trying to get their first victory of NBL season. 36, and it seems like it's coming pretty easily against this Oakland Raiders team, who's only been able to put points on the board by heaving the ball down the field to Souls. Let's see if Pittsburgh, 24 seconds left, can put some more points on the board.
Hand off to Darden over the right side. It looks like they're going to just try to settle for another 3 points as a throw to the flat. And Bomber, the San Francisco 49ers here in the second half early, they've really taken away. Boy, what is that play? I've never seen that play before in my life. But they're taking away the deep downfield and forcing Deshaun Watson to check it down because they're actually finally getting some pressure.
Yeah, once you get pressure, those deep routes, those long developing routes, they just don't happen. And it seems like it's kind of biting the Carolina Panthers offense in the butt a little bit right here. A nice little run there. They run.
It was a nice run, but they ran out of time.
Did they have timeouts? They had three, right?
Yep. You don't get to save those in the second half. Second down and six for Deshaun Watson. Looking deep down the field. It's a horrible throw, and he got rewarded for it as DJ Moore shows off that 99 overall. As he had the drag route just sort of walking underneath, and he takes the shot down the field, and DJ Moore shows why he's one of the best in the NBL. Bomber DJ Moore, it's a matchup nightmare.
Yeah, and he's inside right there. He's underneath. The defender's over the top. And Deshaun Watson says, hey, I'm just going to throw it to my receiver, allow him to make a play. And right there, DJ Gimme Moore does what he always does, and that's to make big plays.
Dropping back to Deshaun Watson. Quick three-step drop. Looks underneath. Has Christian McCaffrey. Good tackle here. And Bomber, the San Francisco 49ers badly need their defense to come up with a stop here inside the red zone to keep this with a one-score game.
Yeah, they do, and this is what it's going to come down to. The Niners can't get down multiple scores. They need a turnover here. You got a buck 28 left in the third quarter. It's time to make a play. Watch the pitch to the right side.
It's a pitch to the right side. It's Christian McCaffrey. Oh, what a shed on the right side. Is that Richard Sherman with the tackle on the right side? Yep, that is. Richard Sherman playing at 142 years old, showing off that he's still got a little athleticism with the shed.
Yeah, Richard Sherman, they got him playing on the right side, too, atop this defense. You don't see a guy at his age at the cornerback position lasting as long as he has. He's currently sitting at 32 years old, 85 speed, 89 XL, and his agility is still 93. So at 6'3", still can kind of move his hips, just lost a lot of that speed and acceleration.
We're down to 6'4", wide set for Deshaun Watson. He's got two to each side, dropping back. Deshaun Watson. Deshaun Watson looks deep down the middle of the field, and boy, you're seeing this from the 49ers, and it's giving me a headache. They keep coming out in the red zone, in zone coverage, audibling to man, and then getting beat every single play, whether it's by the wide receiver right there or whether it's by Deshaun Watson running in. What is the defensive strategy? Switching to man coverage, and cover two man, by the way, inside the 8-yard line.
I think they're overthinking it. So they're coming out in zone coverage, which obviously looks like zone coverage. And then Porter's automatically making his adjustments against zone. And then they're trying to hold on to man at the very end. And it's really not fooling anybody because they got man beaters built into those routes already. And right there, you see James Gonzalez just make a little post route, just hits him outside, kind of a double move post back inside, wide open back at the end zone to get into touchdown.
Let's get appreciate everybody.
52 points over under. They're crushing the over and under right now. I mean, this is a anomaly of a game right now.
Yeah. Big shout out to everybody hanging out with us here. NBL Live Broadcast 268 here on the NBL Network. Appreciate all you hanging out with us on this Wednesday night. I'm OSU. I'm hanging out with my man, the Commissioner Bomber. We got a lot coming up. A lot of things to talk about, which we will get to after the game. 31-21 the score in San Francisco. San Francisco with the ball, throwing that comeback route. And you were rewarded one time, but that time, just great defense. And then a diving face mask to add insult to injury. And Bomber, I don't know if you can hear that, but you can hear the wheels falling off the San Francisco bus.
I didn't know the San Francisco bus had wheels.
Well, it's like a Fred Flintstone bus
on the side falling off at this point.
It's bad. It's on blocks right now. Those blocks have fallen off.
Oh, man. Porter's doing what I thought he would do.
What was that? What was the user there?
He switches off, takes him off the play, and that's one of the ones where you switch on. I think he's so far behind, he thought he was switching somewhere close to the line. He was going to make a play at the quarterback, but instead he took over the cornerback and just took him off the play.
Just pulled him back, was like, hey, man, don't worry. Just give it to him, as they're going to rough the kicker, too. Bomber, the wheels, the panels, the engine block, the transmission, everything has fallen off. The San Francisco bus, it looked like they were in great position down three, and DB doing what DB does, which is completely collapsed looking for their first win.
Yeah, I think somebody mentioned it in our GroupMe chat that if Darth Ben played in games that were like half the amount of length of our current quarter system, which is 6 minutes, that'd be all right.
Yeah. Well, actually, he'd still be winless, but he'd be winless by a lot less margin because he's all the way down three at the half. As Travis Kelce, by the way, seven catches. for the Oakland Raiders, a guy who didn't have a whole lot of suitors in free agency, getting up there in age a little slower, but the Oakland Raiders are happy to have him as he's a shorthanded receiver, second down and eight for Derek Carr on the right side of the screen, looking to cut this back to a 14-point lead, and boy, they need a touchdown bad. Shotgun formation, Taquan Jasper to his left, Carr dropping back. Four-man rush from the Pittsburgh Steelers, waiting, looking. He had a lot of guys open at different times, and then he finds a guy over there. I think that's Taquan Jasper with the catch. It's standing next to Amari Cooper. It's going to bring up a third and five.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, the dependency at the halfback position and tight end position in the passing attack has kind of hindered this offense from really being able to get vertically and open some things up for those players. It seems that they're way too dependent at the tight end halfback position to be utilized in the passing game. So I'd like to see Amari Cooper here on third and five get into the end zone.
Third down and five, shotgun formation for Derek Carr. Taquan Jasper to his left, three wide set, one over to the left side, two over to the right side. Carr dropping back, five-man rush, picked up nicely, looks over the middle of the field, throws it to the wrong guy. Absolutely had the right read, just threw it to the wrong guy. It's going to bring up a fourth and five, and Bomber down 21 here in the third. You got to think they got to go for it. You can't kick a field goal here.
Yeah, you definitely do. I mean, you're down 21 points. Four. It's fourth and five, but it looks like they're going to do it and just decide to be down 18.
All right, they made it. 28-10, the score. Both these games are pretty out of hand. Third and 22, by the way, and sack. Bomber, I think not only has all the stuff fallen off the San Francisco bus, they're starting to sell it on eBay.
What are they paying people for it to take it or what?
No, it's like, it's one of those things where they like list it and the starting bid is 99 cents and nobody's bid on it yet. They're like, right, come on, man.
That's a too high starting bid.
This is a perfectly good San Francisco 49ers transmission. You don't want to miss out on this one. Everybody's like, nah, we good. I'll just have no transmission. I'd rather just have none in my car. As Carolina pouring it on here in the fourth quarter. So, Bomber, fun fact. Let's see if you know this. Do you know which team currently passes the most to their halfbacks and tight ends?
I would say the Oakland Raiders. Is that where we're going with it?
Not. It is the New Orleans Saints. They have.
I would think the New Orleans Saints with a tight end. Yeah, they're tight end heavy.
Well, no. Let's point. So they have, I believe, their tight end has 35 receptions on the year. Their halfback, Alvin Kamara, has 34 receptions, which is 14 more than any other team in the NBL.
Wow,
that's a lot.
That is a fun fact of the day.
Fun fact. Wow, that made me think about it. Watching the Raiders, I looked at the Raiders. Taquan Jasper, their running backs combined only have 21 receptions. The New Orleans Saints make it a life throw into their halfbacks, and they're atop the NFC South.
Man, they've been balling lately. A big win against the Miami Dolphins. The defense was able just to frustrate and fluster Allen Rose, the quarterback for the Miami Dolphins, really changed the outcome of that game. A very impressive win for the New Orleans Saints over the AFC. But we always said it: the NFC, obviously, a very, very much. Just a tougher conference.
Dog eat dog.
All bias included there.
Absolutely, 100%. And I know I bring the profile up. First and 10 on the right side of the screen for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Big lead, handoff to Wilcox over the right side. They're getting down towards the two-minute mark in the third quarter. On the left side of the screen, Carolina and San Francisco. Carolina's been pouring it on here in the second half. They're up 38-21 and driving as they're at the 30-yard line. I formation, two tight ends over on the right side. DJ Moore, the lone wide receiver. Once again, San Francisco show man coverage. I formation. Doesn't look like Christian McCaffrey is in the game right now. I was on second and nine. It's going to be a handoff over the left side. Bounces off his own blocker. He'll get down to the 27-yard line. That is Foreman coming into the game. And no use getting Christian McCaffrey hurt in this late game blowout.
I love the celebration from the fullback there on the left side. But you got Foreman coming up. All he has to do is kind of elude that blocker in front of him because he has him blocked. That could have easily been picked up a first down, but the Carolina Panthers are what we like to call in cruise control right now. I want to bring up one point about the Pittsburgh Steelers. A great job establishing the run today. That might be a formula for success moving forward for this Pittsburgh team.
Yep, they're throwing it. Looking for DJ Moore. Flag down on the play, and it's going to be a hold. So, hey, 4:04 to go, Bomber. They're down 17. San Francisco finally got a stop on third down.
Yeah, right there. You got a drop, essentially. I understand there was a penalty that came up, but they finally got a drop at the wide receiver position from these Carolina Panthers wide receivers who have been phenomenal so far hanging on to the ball.
So I think the over-under on this game was set at 36, 37, 38.
Rightfully so, too,
and,
as well.
Yeah, it's a close 62. So if you pick the under, you actually get two losses this week because it was so bad. Oakland and Pittsburgh, Darden with the carry right up the middle. Yeah, Bomber, this running game for the Pittsburgh Steelers, they have had a problem all year of turning the ball over, especially at the quarterback position. Coming into this game, Jameis Winston had 3 touchdowns and 21 interceptions, but with Darden at the running back position, almost 100 yards on the day, it's taking a lot of pressure off the passing game.
Yeah, it takes pressure off the passing attack. It also opens up the passing attack in the sense of you have guys that normally are sitting there in pass coverage. Now they have to worry about the run. They're the secondary defense on the running game, and now they have to kind of hesitate. It allows your receivers to get open deep down the field, and they've benefited from that tremendously so far, OSU.
Hand off to Matt Breda for the San Francisco 49ers. He'll pick up a couple, and Breda's had a nice game. 7 carries, 46 yards, as Jerick McKinnon went down with that shoulder tear early in the game. They cannot keep him healthy, but Bomber, from the 2 games I've seen of the San Francisco 49ers here on MBL Live, Matt Breda seems like the guy to take over the number one position. He's much more durable, and he still has a lot of that. What do you call it, the juice?
He's got the JUIs. He can make it happen. He's got the juice. He has the ability. He just needs to have the passing attack. Just show a little bit of something so they can't stack the box against this offense.
By the way, Jameis Winston Day, 11 of 17, 267 and 4 touchdowns, no interceptions. By far the best game Jameis Winston has had. Albeit one of those touchdowns was a chuck and a prayer, but the other 3, Bomber, he has been really good today at taking what the defense gives him, working underneath and not just trying to pick up 20 yards at a time.
Yeah, I've only seen one really bad throw, which was the initial throw to start this game.
Yeah.
But since then, he's been electric. He's been nice. He's been confident. He's been consistent. Everything that they want out of Jameis Winston to be for this Pittsburgh Steelers offense.
The 49ers are infirm. I just want to go snuggle under the blanket with my mom and tell him about how mean Porter was. Is 41-21 the score? The Carolina Panthers showing off. And Bomber, this Panthers team, I think most would agree, has been one of the more disappointing teams this cycle just because of the amount of talent they have and the amount of athleticism they have. Are you yet on the train where it looks like the Carolina Panthers are sort of turning it around? Look at this guy go. That's a big fella.
49. Let's
That's
go,
a
baby.
Big fella.
Hey, they're still in it. I mean, right now you still got 3 timeouts. Maybe you get somehow you get the ball back. Maybe onside kick. I wouldn't recommend onside kick. Just kick it off regular. Maybe he'll throw it to you. You score again, and then maybe you get in there as the Pittsburgh Steelers continue to rail it on. We got a big announcement tomorrow, OSU.
Yeah. You're not going to want to miss it. What time is
that? I just got your second message. Never mind.
Well, I mean,
teaser.
No time to talk about it, but now, as they go for the 2-point conversion. He calls a fullback dive. I love it. We got a programming update for MBL Live. We're not going to have MBL Live for about the next 2 weeks. We'll have bonus coverage, though, here on twitch.tv/MBL Network. So hit that follow button. You're still going to see live games here. It's bonus coverage hosted by Bomber. Plenty of great games. Great part about bonus coverage is you get a lot of coverage at times we don't usually have MBL Live, Bomber. We've seen morning games, afternoon games, evening games. So if maybe the evening time isn't the best time for you, you may catch something at a different time that works better.
Yeah, we'll sometimes have bonus coverage on in the morning, middle of the day. I mean, whenever it comes, we'll try to get you some premium games, get you some coverage here, potentially daily on this channel. NBL Live will be returning before the playoffs. I would think a week or two before then.
Yep.
Right now we're sitting at week 10, I think. So we just have some stuff coming up. Big news, actually, that you guys are really going to enjoy.
What do we got coming up tomorrow night? We got Commissioner Corner's podcast, right?
It's
a bad pick.
A bad pass
Ryan
there.
Shazier
Derek Carr just... Shazier, congratulations to him right there, making a nice interception. Nice play, jump on the ball right there as Derek Carr let one get away from him underneath. We got Commissioner Corner podcast tomorrow night, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Then Friday night, we have the action between the Baltimore Ravens and the building the franchise Cincinnati Bengals. Going to be going down Friday night. Both of those are going to be exclusively on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/Matt Bomber League. They're both going to be live streamed. Tomorrow night, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. They don't have the time for you Friday night when we're going to have a stream. And then we'll have another stream for BTF on the weekend, either Sunday or Saturday night.
The Commissioner Corner tomorrow, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, over on YouTube, youtube.com/Madden Bomber League. Tune in there. We'll talk a little bit more about what's going on. A bit of a big announcement. I got some fun topics to talk about. If you haven't tuned into a CC podcast, it's a lot of fun. Again, 7 o'clock tomorrow night. Over on YouTube, youtube.com/Madden Bomber League. As both these games winding down, San Francisco takes a timeout. Sure. Minute 56 to go, down 14, and your defense hasn't really done anything all day, but you think you've got a shot at it. Hey, how about that? You You keep that confidence, DB. That's what makes it fun. 41-27, Carolina on top in that one. Handoff to Christian McCaffrey. He gets taken down. Timeout, I assume. Yep, timeout. They're going to make this game go.
Just ran it up the middle. I mean, it's still technically a 14-point game, a 3rd and 8. You get one miracle. You get an onside, get it back. You know, you're right within striking distance here. Now you just got to get him off the field on this 3rd and 8. Let's see if Porter, Woo! I almost called him TP. Bad Woo! Pass by Jameis Winston there. Finally gets picked off.
Yeah, 35-10. They decide to throw it on 3rd and inches, and Winston throws it just directly to the defender. So a slim bright spot is Christian McCaffrey breaks a tackle. He's down the right side, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, inside the 10, down to the 7-yard line. And Bomber now with a minute 40 to go. Carolina just pulled off a big play. They're at the 7-yard line. I know Porter. San Francisco's used 2 timeouts. He's trying to get into the end zone now. He wants to lay it on him. If he could get 9 points, he would.
It's knees and GGs at this time. I mean, he can knee it out. The game will be over. And that's what I expect him to do. He is the gentleman.
No, he is not. He's like the anti-gentleman. I thought he'd just load up as a – that's a bad throw that gets rewarded once again. Bob, we haven't seen the best usury in the secondary in either of these games.
Yeah, it seems like you got the defense right on top of them, and you switch on, and you just take them off. It's almost as if you're trying to entice a big catch or a big play right now defensively, but luckily for the Steelers, up 35-10, they just blew this game wide open. They've been phenomenal offensively. The running attack for Pittsburgh has been something we haven't seen much yet from a 0-18. Maybe this is some hope moving into the future.
Oh. Derek Carr just got obliterated. 4:19 to go in that one. Carolina running out the clock. They are, what's their record moving to with this win?
The Carolina Panthers firmly in a strong spot right now in the NFC South. They do have the Saints kind of nipping at the tail here. The Saints are 5-4. The Buccaneers, I forgot about the Bucs, they're 5-4. And the Carolina Panthers were 4-4 going into this game, so now they're 5-4.
And the Atlanta Falcons are like 5-4, but like slightly less 5-4.
they're exactly like 5-4 if it was 3-6.
There it is.
Still in the hunt, believe it or not. That division has turned into a very like
that's true every year.
Low.
Last season, might have been the season before. It was the only division that had 4 teams above 500 in their division, or at 500 and above. The worst team.
We might see that again.
Listen. Atlanta's kind of a mess right now. We'll see.
You know, I mean, it's the best out of any other. Well, you could see it in the AFC South. I just don't expect the Titans to do it. They have not proven that they're above 500 team. But the AFC South and the NFC South, the two South divisions, have been pretty tough top to bottom.
What about the NFC
strong.
West?
The NFC West has not been the best. The Rams are at 5-4. I don't think a lot of people are really talking about the Los Angeles Rams too much. The Seahawks coming off a big victory today in overtime. They got a pick six to win that game against the Jacksonville Jaguars. Kind of a surprising turn of events there. And the Arizona Cardinals are at 3-6. They're kind of playing that they're still in striking distance as well, as the 49ers are now going to fall to 0-9.
We'll stay full screen with this Pittsburgh-Oakland game as it winds down. A big win for the Carolina Panthers. But Bomber, that's back-to-back NBLIs. Boy, the San Francisco 49ers... I know they're winless, but they might be the best winless team we've ever seen in the NBL. They've put on a tough game for about 2.5 quarters.
Yeah, they play a really tough game. They're very aggressive down the field, and it just seems like that aggressiveness might get the best of them at times. But I believe in this team. I believe they should petition the league for 4-minute quarters. It might make them better because they'll be able to hang in the game a little bit longer, and with their aggressive play style, it might help as the Raiders get lucky there and strip the ball. From Jameis Winston. Two turnovers late from Jameis Winston in what was a pretty decent game for him. Actually, a really good game. Probably his best game of the season.
Get a little loose late in the game as 35-10 Pittsburgh on top. Don't forget CC Podcast tomorrow, 7 o'clock Eastern time over on YouTube, youtube.com/MaddenBomberLeague. You'll also find Bomber, BTF, you said Friday night?
Yeah, building the franchise is going to be this Friday night. Tomorrow night, obviously Thursday, Commissioner Corner Podcast, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We talked about that. We're going to be talking about everything in the NBL, what's going on. We also have a very big announcement that's going to affect the NBL very positively. Very excited. You guys are going to be like, what? I can't believe this is happening. Yeah, it's some really cool stuff. And then also Friday, it's going to be building the franchise. Cincinnati Bengals, they're going to be taking on the Baltimore Ravens. Then we have their game next week as well. So we'll have back-to-back episodes. That'll be episode number, I think, 4 and 5. It might be 3 and 4, actually. 3 and 4. Yeah, it'll be episode number 3 on Friday and then number 4 on the weekend.
The Oakland Raiders today, by the way, with Taequann Jasper, who is one of the best young running backs in the NBL. 26 passes, 4 rushes. it's
That's not going to get it done.
It's not a balance. Deep pass, looking over the top. Oh, that's a pretty throw. Oh, that's a pretty throw. It's a touchdown. The Raiders getting obliterated in this game, but finding Switzer over the top. And Bomber, you want to talk about my favorite thing that they added in this game from Madden 18 to Madden 19 is the ability to make that throw exactly.
Yeah, a little drop in the bucket over the top, put some air underneath it, and you're not able just to switch on and just somehow you're running faster than the receiver. It really holds its distance in the air, and we like to see that in the game. I like the lob pass now, being able to put it up and over top of the defense.
All right, you might as well go for it. 35-17, Oakland, 3:04 to go. Going for the onside kick against these Pittsburgh Steelers. Pittsburgh primed to get their first win on the season. And Bomber, I know, you know, a lot about how a team looks, how a team performs is based on the opponent, how they play. But from an execution standpoint, if you take out the last 2 minutes that we've seen and you go for the part of the game where Pittsburgh, it was rolling, this is probably the best executed game plan we have seen from the Steelers this year and a reason why they're getting their first win today.
Yeah, and it's been credited to the running attack. The running attack has been so phenomenal. The defense was able to get pressure to Derek Carr. They benefited from a couple overthrows from Derek Carr. It all played out well. I like what I saw here from the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Sure, Planet, take those timeouts, man. 2:59 to go. Pittsburgh, and I think, Bomber, we said it earlier, the big reason why the Pittsburgh Steelers look so good today was that rushing attack with Darden up over 100 yards, and they didn't shy away from it at any point. Even when they were in like a third and four, they were committed to the run game, and Darden looked phenomenal. That offensive line played really well, and it allowed Jameis Winston to not have to make too many difficult throws.
Yeah, Jameis Winston. They're still throwing it. And they're still throwing it with Jameis Winston, as he's made a couple suspect, questionable passes so far today towards the end of the game. But the outside of the first throw of the game, up until recently, he's had his best game of the season by far, without question. He probably still has, even including a couple of those suspect throws as 3rd and 11. They should just run the ball here. I don't see the Raiders really coming back.
Yeah, a little draw play to Darden. Spin move, trying to get to the first down marker. He's down to the 32-yard line. 2:46 and counting, going to set up a 4th and 2. They're just going to set up another field goal. Bomber, by the way, this game, it did get over the 36.
Yeah, both games had a lot of high scoring. I like these two halfbacks, though, from these teams. I like Darden. I like Jasper, two Madden-created quarterbacks here in the NBL. They have a lot of talent, a lot of ability to elude the defense, especially in the backfield or right at the line of scrimmage. It seemed like they're always falling forward. As you saw Darden right there, there's just a little move, got outside on the draw play, and then he was still continuing to fight forward. I like what I've seen from both of these halfbacks. They definitely have a bright future in the NBL.
Yeah, that's sort of the thing, Bob, when we talk about teams who are struggling. At times, you just got to just run the ball. Is your stream buffering at this point?
Yeah, it's been buffering this entire time. I mean, the last, like, 3 minutes. 2 minutes, real life.
Listen, if it keeps buffering, we're just gonna go. It's 38-17.
Yeah,
it's 38-17.
But it's good to see teams establishing the run game. It's hard to stay with it, especially when you're struggling. When you get to 0-6, 0-7, 0-8, you don't want to stay with the run. You want a big play. You want the lead. You're yearning for an opportunity to put points on the board, and running it is obviously a slower, more methodical way to move the chains. And it's not as fancy. It's not as fun.
Ball's out. Picked up by Pittsburgh. Woo! The turnovers, though, Bomber, have been a problem for this Oakland Raiders team. And today it wasn't so much Derek Carr on his own. Boy, there was a lot of fumbles from everybody, wide receivers, running backs. This Pittsburgh Steelers team, very opportunistic, are able to force a ton of turnovers. 5 turnovers on the day. So Pittsburgh, winless on the season, turnover problems. They end up +3 today, and that's a big reason why they're going to move into the ranks of the one-win club.
Yeah, Ryan Shazier has been phenomenal. He's got an interception. He's forced 2 fumbles. The ability to strip the ball out, he's looked great. We haven't said Khalil Mack's name too much for the Oakland Raiders, predominantly because they've given up 38 points. The defense has not looked good in Oakland. We talked about Carl Joseph as a player to watch. Where was he? I didn't see him. We saw him in the last NBL Live game. He looked pretty good. He made a nice jump interception. I believe that was NBL Live broadcast 265. Haven't seen anything from him yet today. And you know,
they're
it's just kind
it
of
again,
a sad performance.
Way, it's 2nd and 13. They're throwing the ball.
Yeah, trying to get some Some points down the field are trying to move the chains to knee this game out. The Pittsburgh Steelers are trying to just continue to move the chains here up 38-17.
13-22, 288, and 5 touchdowns, 1 interception for Jameis Winston today, who I think even with the performance today, I think most people expected Mason Rudolph probably wasn't going to get another chance. But with the performance today, I think most people going, yeah, it is Jameis Winston's team as he tries to throw another interception. They're not even killing the clock. They're just... I don't know what's going on, Bomber. What's Gibbs doing over in Pittsburgh? Let's get a little analysis here.
He hasn't been up. They've been 0-8. They're trying to give the fans something here, trying to move the chains, keep it moving, just need the game out. The Raiders were burning the timeouts. Yeah, trying to be a little aggressive down the field, overthinking it maybe, as Winston has looked at his worst probably in the last 2 minutes.
All right, yeah, we're done with this. This stream it's turned bad. It's gotten real.
It was good during the good times. So I mean,
it was good. It was like a
perfect.
Givestream realized we were all watching it and was like, whoa! You don't want to see that. He flipped his lag switch. Z-Star in the chat saying DB needs to be next for 40 days.
Darth Vin? Nah, 40 days is retired.
It's enough. Teaching's no fun. A reminder, folks, be sure to tune in to the Commissioner Corner podcast tomorrow, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, youtube.com/MadamBomberLeague. No MBO live for the next 2 weeks or so, and we will let you know why. That'll be tomorrow night, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, youtube.com/MadamBomberLeague. And then Friday night, we'll be building the franchise, Cincinnati Bengals. Same place, youtube.com/MadamBomberLeague. Hit that follow button. You should know each and every time we go live here on the MBL Network with bonus coverage. Bomber, it has been a fun night. 2 really good broadcasts, and I'm going to miss doing MBL Live for a while.
Yeah, we'll be back shortly. It won't be too long. We'll be holding it down with some bonus coverage in the meantime, between time, and we'll be back before the playoffs here, MBL Season 36.
All right. Thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in tonight on MBL Live 268. We're going to get out of here. Have yourselves a wonderful night, a wonderful week. Stay warm out there if you're in the cold. Stay cool if you're in the hot. For my co-host, Bomber, I am OSU. Once again, thank you so much for tuning in to MBL Live 268. Make sure you tune into all of our MBL Network programming, and we'll see you next time right here on MBL Live.
I just want to say, hey, man, this is T.O., the cover athlete of the Madden 19 Hall of Fame edition, and you're watching the gold standard of the franchise mode, the MBL Network.